Every day of the year, industry and motor vehicles spew out gases, which, when hit by sunlight, change into acids. The acids collect on clouds and when it rains, come straight down onto us.
Marble is a common building material, and what we have here is some marble chips. I'm going to add some acidity here, about 10 times more acid than the most acid rainwater, but you can see immediately that the acid attacks the marble and starts to dissolve it.
It's not what you'd want in your cup of coffee, so Dr. Greg Ayres from Australia's science agency, CSIRO, is collecting samples of rain and measuring them for acidity. pH is measured from 0 to 14. Tap water is neutral at 7. On the alkaline side, seawater is around 8. And at the acidic end, orange juice and soft drinks are around pH 2 or 3. Unpolluted rainwater should measure around pH 5, and any measurement under 5 would be considered acid rain. As Australia is sparsely populated, its cities are far apart, and it has no neighbours, the readings are not very high. In areas where there are smelters and power stations, however, the problem of acid rain is far greater.
The major effects are on forests and on rivers and lakes, where the acid rain causes the soil or the water to become so acidified that trees won't grow. In fact, they can even die completely. Or in rivers and lakes, they can become so acidified that they won't support any form of aquatic life.
CSIRO is working with Australian industry to help accurately and inexpensively track the spread and levels of acidic particles before they become a health or environmental hazard.